Hi everybody, my name is Bek and thank you for clicking on today's video. I'm so excited to be sharing with you guys my top 3 tips on surviving your first trimester. I'm officially 14 weeks pregnant, which means I'm entering my second trimester and I'm so excited. I'm so happy, literally my cheeks are hurting because I'll tell you all about that in the upcoming video. But if you want to know my top 3 tips, then stay tuned. Holy dooly.
No way. Oh, no way. Oh, my goodness.
That's my rainbow.
I know they're not peanut M&Ms.
Thank you. Congratulations.
As I said in my introduction, my name is Bek. If this is our first time meeting, I'll give you a bit of a run through on the pregnancy thus far. So this is our 4th pregnancy, but our 3rd child. So last year we did experience, sadly, a miscarriage, and I was about 8 and a bit weeks pregnant for that. So I had about a month worth of morning sickness for that one, and then I got to hit that refresh button. Praise the Lord, because I am actually really excited that God has blessed us with a healthy pregnancy. So I'm going to be sharing with you my top 3 tips on how I survived this last first trimester. When it comes to my personal life, it's very different to, I guess, most people's circumstances. I am a full-time working mom. I am a primary school teacher, so I don't necessarily have long hours, but I have 2 tiny humans. Amira is turning 4 in about 2 months, and Zoe is turning 2 in about 3 months, which means that we have pickups and drop-offs. So even though my work day is officially 7:45 to 3:30, our kids have this really special, unique arrangement where Zoe goes to family daycare and Amira is off to kindy, which means by the time I get home, it's around 5:30. My work day, I'm leaving home at 7:15 and I'm getting home at 5:30 to then start the nighttime routine. So surviving the first trimester was a real struggle, and that's just being honest, because I feel like depending on your pregnancy and your knowledge about your body, it can be absolutely shocking or it could be a complete bliss. And looking back on the last 2 pregnancies with Amira and Zoe, Amira's pregnancy, it was definitely rough, and it was more so rough because I didn't really know how to work with my body to get through the first trimester. Where with Zoe, I had learnt what my body needed and I was able to get through it a little bit more smoothly. The other thing that can make a huge impact is your workload and like your family commitments. So with Amira being my firstborn, I was doing relief work, we didn't really have many commitments, so I could really just listen to my body. Where now, being a full-time worker and having 2 kids under the age of 4, I don't have the luxury of coming home after a big day of work and having a nap. So after all of that rambling, I'm going to be sharing with you guys my top 3 tips that really have helped me to survive the last 13 weeks. Tip number 1 is to be kind on yourself. Your body is going to go through a world full of changes, and your body will react differently to everybody else's. So just because one person was able to do X, Y, and Z through their first trimester, doesn't mean that you will be able to, doesn't mean that you should just stop and give up. Absolutely not. Be kind on yourself for the things that you're gonna have to adjust and adapt to, because you are growing a tiny little human in your body, and things that you could do pre-pregnancy and now your body is telling you not to do, just embrace it, go with the flow. It really is such a short season of your life. 13 weeks, even though when you're in your first trimester goes so unbelievably slow, when you finally get to 14 weeks and you look back on it, it makes your heart just be like, oh, what was wrong with all that? It just goes so fast with hindsight. And the reason why I'm saying that tip number 1 is to be kind on yourself straight up is for the next 2 tips. So the second tip is listen to your body when it comes to your exhaustion levels. It takes, I find, a lot of energy in that first trimester to establish little bub and making sure that everything is working well. It seems like between weeks, I don't know, 1 and 4, when you don't even know you're pregnant, things are fine. Week 4 to 6, you can kind of see that there's a slight bit of change. And then I feel like at 6 weeks, that's when my exhaustion just kicked in hardcore. We have been using our slow cooker a lot because then I can set it in the morning when I have the energy. So in the afternoon when I am completely exhausted from a full day's work, I don't even have to do anything. I can just serve it up for the kids, cool it down, and then let them eat dinner. So definitely listen to your body and your exhaustion levels. It's perfectly fine to have sleeps and naps when you can grab them. Don't feel like you're failing at anything or like any negative thoughts because you're pregnant. Like, your body is going through so many changes and it's perfectly fine to accept the fact that your exhaustion levels are higher. I, in the first trimester, couldn't get up anymore to exercise in the morning, and then I was too tired in the afternoon to exercise. So exercising has definitely not been my focus this trimester. And because this is a pregnancy that has followed a miscarriage, all my medical practitioners that I've consulted with have said to definitely be a bit more cautious about my core and how I'm working out. When I did find out that I was pregnant, I was still doing walks in the morning and getting my heart rate up, and I was trying to do some stretches with some yoga and just limited core exercises, more so like my legs and my arms. But I definitely reached a stage where I needed to listen to my body and I stopped just for now, because now that I'm 14 weeks, I definitely feel like I've got the energy that I can start getting my exercise routine back up, really still being mindful of the fact that I am carrying a human inside of me, and I know what it's like to lose a child, and I don't want to put this child in any danger whatsoever, or even have the thought in my head like, was that the reason why? So it's just, in my head is a very mixed battle of like good and bad thoughts all at once, but that's a whole nother video. And if this is your second child, open communication with your partner that you may be tired at the end of the day. Try and put things into place so it doesn't get lumped on them. Make sure you're showing lots of gratitude with, you know, words of affirmation or presents or like whatever their love language is. Make sure you're showing them that you appreciate them, even though you physically just aren't able to do things at that stage because of exhaustion. And my third and final tip is feed your morning sickness. I wish that someone had told me in my first pregnancy about this. I kind of figured it out maybe halfway through my pregnancy with Zoe. So for this one, I just listened to my body, ate what I could eat. I really communicated with Michael things that I couldn't touch or couldn't smell or couldn't see. There's so many like food aversions that I've had, and they're all really strange, and it changes day by day. So it's definitely not a hard and fast rule. Before falling pregnant at the beginning of the year, if you've watched some of my videos, I was on the healthy bandwagon. I tried going back to a paleo-based lifestyle where I wasn't eating refined sugars or wheat or dairy, and just trying to be as whole foods approach as I could. When I got pregnant, my body craved carbs and it craved dry, starchy food. I really couldn't look too much at fruit and vegetables, and even some proteins really just turned my stomach. I've had different cravings pretty much every single week in this first trimester. I've loved bagels and then all of a sudden hated bagels. I have loved eating sour worms and then hating sour worms. I loved eating LCM bars and then no longer needed LCM bars. Like every week, I think as the baby has been developing and growing different things, my appetite and my ability to eat food has been, oh my goodness, like a roller coaster ride. It has been up and down, everywhere, loop-de-loop, and I am just embracing it. I can happily say that now that I'm at 14 weeks, my diet is definitely coming more in line with the diet that I used to have. I'm able to handle more proteins now than I could in my first trimester. I still need things to be as dry and bland as they possibly could, but I'm able to snack on fruit and I'm actually happy to eat vegetables again. And I'm trying to get away from all of those packet foods and going back to the whole foods. It's absolutely fine that your diet's going to change. Don't go overboard because you don't want to be putting on extra weight that is then harder to work off, but you just want to be able to make sure that you're feeding your morning sickness so that you don't get to a point where you're feeling so sick that you couldn't even stomach eating food anymore. Like always in pregnancy, listen to your body. Don't feel like anyone's going to judge you. You're pregnant. You're just trying to survive this first trimester, and it really is quite difficult, and you just have to find what works for you, because our bodies are made so differently, our bobs are so differently. I've noticed my pregnancies have been all different. So once again, my top three tips are to be kind to yourself, sleep when you can because exhaustion is real, and feed your morning sickness. Remember to just listen to your body, to enjoy being pregnant. Every day is a gift from God, and it's just such a special time, and the first trimester will come and go quicker than you think it will. So please comment below if you have any first trimester hacks that really work for you. I would love to hear from you. If you've liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that red subscribe button and come along on this rainbow baby journey with us, and tap the bell to get notified, because sometimes YouTube doesn't tell you when I upload next. This parenting gig doesn't come with a rule book. We only have each other, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.